a quick video response to Pyro. He's made another kind of outrageous statement. It's very Matt-like. He says the evidence doesn't fit the theory of cause and effect. Apparently, cause and effect is just a theory. And, that the deterministic view of reality has just been, it's untenable. The evidence just makes it untenable. It's just, it's over. You can't be a reasonable person and cling to that. It's clinging now, it's some sort of religion of determinism. Old archaic dogma. It's just so irritating. We have nothing. I mean, the volume of evidence is that everything we observe, everything in our world, from our computers to our automobiles to airplanes, none of them do anything spontaneously. None of them do anything freely. They all follow the laws of physics. There is no unexplainable phenomenon, okay? I mean, even human spontaneous combustion, they figured out that, yes, humans are full of fat and they basically turn into a candle and slowly burn. There's always explanations and we find the explanations. We our building collapses and we find, the bolts were this and that and blah, blah, blah. And there's always something. There's always a reason things happen. There is a cause. And when you think about things like the integrated circuits in your computer, the hundreds of them, with the billions of connections, literally, I think, at least multi-millions, minute, tiny stuff, and nothing spontaneously happens in that environment, all right? It's very consistent, it acts very reliably. The big gap in the evidence for him is the fact that when we start picking apart the most minute particles in the universe, we see some things that just don't add up, that just seem, they appear to be broken or messed up. And he uses this word seem. It seems like we have free will, so therefore he can cling to that conclusion. Well, I'll get to that later. I'll stick with the experimentation. Because look at the experiments. The experiments are these theoretical ones, mostly. And then when we can construct some hardware, a reasonable analogy might be doing a dissection of a human being with a hammer. Okay, I mean, you can certainly do it, but the view you're going to get is not going to be of the real thing, because you're going to have to smash it to pieces and rip it up and tear it up. It's not going to be precise enough for you to gain any real, you'll gain some information, but you won't gain the whole story. You won't see the real picture, but you'll do too much damage in the process. And that's how our experiments on these microparticles is. It's crude experimentation. And if any place is to be suspect, if the evidence of any part of our world is to be suspect, that would be the suspect evidence. And so then going to the seams, what seems to us to be free will, but we can see it. Deers act like deers, okay? Cats act like cats. Dogs act like dogs. Lizards act like lizards. I mean, we see it in all these other biological machines. They act like machines. They are programmed machines. We understand that. We can appreciate that. We can see that, all right? They do what they do. They do what they're programmed, what their reflexes compel them to do. And we are, again, a reflexive organism. So yes, we are more complex, we have more connections, more reflexes tied to all these elaborate vocabulary that we have in our head. So we're not just reflexively reacting to visuals and sensations, but we're also reacting internally to symbolic representations in our head. So yes, we're more complex and we have more reflexes, but that's all it is. It's just an increase in capacity to do something interesting and weird, because we have more permutations. All right, if you have three dice, you only have a certain number of things that can happen with three dice when you roll them. All right, if you have 500 dice, then you have a lot larger pool of possibility. And that's all it is. We have a larger pool of possibility, but we are still confined. There is no freedom. The possibility is still narrowed to what those 500 dice can do. All right? They can't roll sevens and eights and tens and all that other stuff, the single dice. All right? So there's a limitation, a confinement. There's no such thing as freedom here. All right? We are programmed machines, and that's just the way it is. The universe started on a course billions and billions of years ago, all right, and it's on its course. And your freedom, my freedom, there's no freedom that's going to change that course. We are going to play our role as the molecules go through their recycling process, as they all of us are made of the past. I mean, we have the dust of stars that we're made out of, and each piece of that dust had its own life, its own mission. Okay, it went through its own course, and we're the end product of, we're the current present product, and there'll be a future product. I mean, it will go keep doing its thing. It will still keep moving through the filters of complexity and connection that takes place naturally in the universe. But there are limited rules that confine how matter will behave, how each single piece of it will behave, how every little bit of it will behave. And those rules govern us, and certainly govern us on the level of the biosphere we exist on and our consciousness exists on. There's no freedom here. It is a programmed device, all right? It doesn't know Latin without being taught Latin. There's no magic in here. This is just such bullshit. The preponderance of the evidence is on the side of a deterministic view of the universe, and is the extraordinary claim to sit there and say cause and effect is not an accurate or reasonably superior to anything else description of our reality. The evidence for anything beyond cause and effect is highly suspect. That's the best you can say for it. It's highly suspect. All right, enough said. Kind of short video. Well, moderate.